But first this morning, WA's health authorities are on high alert with a woman being treated at Sir Charles Gairdner Hospital with Ebola-like symptoms. Whether or not she has the deadly virus is still to be confirmed, but she is in isolation as we speak. Rachel Carey is covering the story for us this morning. And Rachel, this is a devastating disease, as we've seen already, particularly in West Africa. Understandably, authorities here not taking any chances.
They're not taking any chances, Tim. And when this woman first started displaying symptoms that could potentially be Ebola, authorities did isolate her. She was transferred from Royal Perth Hospital to Sir Charles Gairdner Hospital overnight. Now, a special airtight ambulance was used for that transfer overnight. We only have two of these ambulances in the state, and paramedics were also required to wear protective gear. It's believed this woman, aged in her 60s, was in West Africa 10 days ago. And we also understand that she is an African national. She is currently undergoing tests as we speak to determine if she has the deadly virus, Tim.
Rachel, what's the latest information that you're getting from health authorities?
Well, so far the hospital has issued a statement confirming the woman is being treated for the virus. They've also confirmed that this isn't the first Ebola scare that we've had in WA. They say another person was tested a week ago, but thankfully they returned a negative result. The hospital says that even if the woman does have Ebola, the standard of care here in Australia is such that it is very unlikely that it will be transmitted to another person. The health department has told us they won't be commenting on this health scare on camera. Tim.